Hello there, Ali here from Sports Templates, and today we're going to be working on this new hoodie template. So with this template, you're going to get five files. You get a front view of the hoodie with a zipper. You get another front view of the hoodie with the kangaroo pocket. You also get three quarters view of the kangaroo pocket and three quarters view of the zipper hoodie, as well as the back view. So again, these are the PSDs. You got the three-quarters view zipper hoodie, the front view zipper hoodie, three-quarters view kangaroo pocket hoodie, as well as the front view, and finally the back view. All of these PSDs are in 8K resolution, so you can zoom in really closely and still get a sharp and nice image. So if you zoom in here, you can see the level of details. So today I'm going to be making this Green Bay Packers hoodie. So let's get started. All right. So first off, I prepared this library to help me get things done a little bit easier. So we go to the editable parts and we can go to add your design here. Double click, you know, violet means this is a smart object. So if you double click on this icon, it opens up in a new layer. So let's grab the Packers logo. And let's have it nice and centered. We also have the Nike logo. If you want a good placement on the right chest, you can just place it on top of this your logo placeholder. All right, remove your logo. And then we need to hide the grid. Click Control S to save. And coming back, we can see it here. I think it's a little bit low, so we can bring it up a little bit and make it just a tiny bit smaller. All right, much better. Next, we need to change the color of the different parts of the hoodie. So if you go to the front here, since I have the library ready, I can just click on a color and it automatically changes. I'm gonna pick the yellow for the hood interior, as well as the hoodie interior. And then the zipper piece, usually I like to make it just a little bit darker than the main color. Yeah, something like this. And the zipper, we can have it in the same color, just a little bit lighter. Maybe something like this. Then the straps and the plastic parts, just keep them as it is. And then the cuffs. What's left is just the sleeves. So if you go to the right sleeve, we can make like some kind of an interesting design here. I already have one included. So if I turn it on, looks like this. Hide the grid, Control S, and it already applies on the right sleeve. We just need to change the base sleeve color. So pick the same color. Then let's do the same on the left sleeve. Turn on the design, or you can add your own custom design. And also I'm gonna add the Nike logo on his left arm. And let's make it white. Hide the grid, Control S to save. All right, just notice two things. First of all, I need to push this Nike logo a little bit lower and a little bit to the back. And we need to make this one white. So let's start with the sleeve. Let's push it a little bit lower and to the back a bit. Control S. And now let's do the one on the chest. Double click. And let's make it white. Control S. Now what's left is we can just change the background. I have two options for the background. We have the color splash, where you can just go in and change the background color and maybe change the background text. So let's do like Packers hoodie design. I'm not sure. Or whatever you think is appropriate. All right, Packers hoodie. I think that's all right. Or we can just use the plain background like this. Or we can just remove it at all and have a transparent design to use it to show your clients or just put it on your website. I've also made this same hoodie in the front view and the back view. If you want to compare these mockups with what's already on the NFL shop, for example, this is pretty much kind of like a similar hoodie, but with this one you get much more control. I don't know if this is me just saying it, but I'd say you get a much better lighting that you can edit. So if you want less reflections, you can just turn off the reflections, or you can change the opacity to like 50% or bring it back. If you want more intense lighting, you can just change the sliders here and use it to get the exact look and feel that you're after. Same thing goes for shadows. If you want more shadows, you can just duplicate the shadows layer and you get more intense shadows. And overall, all of this is happening at 8K resolution. So you always get these fine threads and even like the small cotton bumps that you get on clothing. So that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. New video, since we're planning to release new products every month in 2018. So stay tuned. Hey.